Hi there, my name is Mitch Romazhensky, and from this video you will know how pipes can improve the performance of your Angular application. And before we start, don't forget to check out my new Angular material theming workshop. There you will find everything about proper theming. The link will be in the video description. And now subscribe to my channel and we're getting started. All right, so let's get started and let me show you the application I prepared for you. So this is the very simple application which has just two additional services, users and theory. And let's start with the users. So this is just regular service which has read-only property users. There you can see the users which has ID and name. And also we have the theory service, which is the list of theories like quantum theory, theory of relativity, and it has get theory method. You can see right here, and it gets user ID and finds inside the array the object which has the same user ID and returns this object. And this is how we are using this inside the app component. Here we inject those both services, user service and theory service. Then we have get theory, which is takes this user ID, and then we call this get theory method for our theory service and return the certain theory. And this is how it looks inside the template. We go in the loop ng4, and here we print the username, and then we use get theory method inside our template in order to fetch the title of the theory. And this is how it looks right here. Let me zoom in. So this is what our for each renders, and it looks like everything works. And everything looks fine until we try to console log something here, like user ID, whatever. And now let's go back, and wow, we see how many calls here. Four, one, two, three, four. Yeah, four calls for every user. So this is quite a lot. Because, and it is useless call. You see, nothing has been changed, but it was called. And the thing is that when you use some function inside the template, everything here inside will be triggered every time the change detection run. And change detection runs quite often, I should say. As example, we can have as example host binding, and we can do something on the click. Let's say we want to console log some message every time we clicked something, right? And if we now try to click around, why it doesn't work? I have to use host listener. Yeah, here we go. And let's remove it from here. Good. And now if I click, and you see every time I click on my component, it triggers one more time the call of our get theory function, which is really insane. And now can you imagine if we would do the HTTP call inside this function? It would be terrible for our performance, and we have to find the way how we can implement this without such a heavy impact on our performance. And this is where pipes can help us. Let me implement solution for now, and then I will explain what's going on. So we're going to create a new pipe. So I will use the VS Code extension called NX Console. So it kind of helper for Angular CLI. So it allows us to generate pipes very easily. So I generate pipe with a name theory, and I say that, okay, I skip tests, and I will declare it inside app module. And I click run button, and it should generate proper pipe for me. So here we go. You can see the pipe right there, and let's fix type. So here I know that value mi will be the number. Args, so far I leave it as it is, and sorry, I don't want to write interfaces for my theories object, so I will place it as an any. And here we will also console log the value, and here the value will be what we provide inside template. So I can do the next. So I can remove this everything, and I can apply my pipe right here. So this key should be the same like this one. Okay, so I applied my pipe right here, and here we have to perform some logic. So we have to fetch proper theory for our user, and we can do it by injecting some service and reuse it. And namely, I'm going to inject my theory service. Here we go. And right here I can basically return theory get theory and provide the value, or better, let's rename value to user ID, so it's going to be more clear what kind of data we get here. And now we can close this and adjust this part, so I can wrap it into the braces, and let's say this is can be optional, and I can fetch the title right here. Okay, so what happens now? We apply the theory pipe for our user right here. So inside the pipe, this user ID will be as a first parameter. And here we do just the console log to see which ID we path, and then we return the theory for this user. And now let's have a look how it looks like. So nothing has been changed. However, you can see that we called this transform method, basically what did before our method, how we called it, this one get theory, but remember it was called, I don't know how many times, a lot of times. However, the pipe called only twice. And this is because by default pipes are pure. So it has such a property, pure, true, it's by default. And this pure means that this transform method will be executed only if this parameter, this first value, has been changed. In our case, it was not changed, so it will not be triggered every time change detection runs. But if we replace it with the false, it will behave the same way like if it was just a function inside a template. So with this, you can decrease drastically your performance. So let's revert it back. But since we are talking about pipes, let me show you how you can path additional parameters to your custom pipes. As example, if we want to tell pipe to fetch some specific property, we can do it like this, but we can also path it as a argument for the pipe. So I can remove it right here, and this is arguments for the pipe which come right here. And we can say that there will be a property which we're going to fetch, right? And it will be either title string, or it might be also the string user ID, if I remember right. Where is this? Here we go, title and user ID string. Yeah, I was right. So this is property we can path to it, and then we could change it a little bit like this, and then we can say that if theory exists, we will return what we're going to return theory, and we say that some property, yeah, like this. So if we save everything here, we should not see any difference. Then we can say like, I want to this time user ID. And after reload, we see the IDs of the user. So cool. And what else? Let's revert it back to the title. Sometimes, as I mentioned, that you may perform some HTTP calls right there. And it means that you will return observables, right? So we can emulate this like here. So I will return the observable from this pipe. And we know that pipes, you can apply multiple pipes. Yeah. So I can also apply a sync pipe next to theory, and you can see it still works. Yeah. But if I remove this async, you see that will be object. Yeah. Because here we will get the observable. So I will revert it back. And this is how you can reduce amount of unnecessary calls in your templates. All right, guys, that was it. I hope you're enjoying my videos. And if you like it and you like what I'm doing and you want to express your gratitude, the best thing you can do is to share this or any another my video with your colleagues. This is really the best thing you can do. And of course, I'm waiting for feedback in the comment section. And now, stay safe, have a productive week, and see you in the future.